Let us consider the uses of dimensional analysis. In fact, dimensional analysis we take mainly for three different purposes. One, whether the equation given to us is dimensionally correct or not, we can check up. That's what actually we call it as checking the correctness of the given equation using dimensions. So let us take this way, the uses we are just going to discuss about. First use is to check the correctness of equations. Correctness of equations. Whether the given equation to us is dimensionally correct or not, we can check it. Let us take some known equations to us. We in fact know V is equal to U plus AT. That is one of the equations of motion what we know from one dimensional motion of the body. When we consider V is equal to U plus AT, we can understand U is initial velocity, V is final velocity, A is uniform acceleration of the body, and T is the time taken. Now in this regard, whether this equation is dimensionally correct or not, we just can check. Let us consider the quantities towards left hand side first. There is in fact only one quantity we have, that is the final velocity of the body. So what is the dimensional formula of this quantity? Let us write. It is LT inverse. Similarly, when we write the dimensions towards the quantities of right hand side equation of the equation, U, it is LT inverse plus, as it is we have to take, A for acceleration uniform value, LT rest to the power minus 2, and T is the time taken. Therefore, the dimensional formula we can write it as T. Now simplifying this right hand side values, LT inverse plus, again this becomes LT inverse. But according to dimensions, LT inverse plus LT inverse again will be LT inverse. So if you look at this left hand side value of dimensional formula is equal to the dimensional formula towards right hand side of the equation. That means when you are finding the dimensional formula is same on both sides, we now can conclude the given equation is dimensionally correct. So whether the equation is dimensionally true or false, making use of the dimensional formulae of those quantities supplied in that equation, we can just decide that. So similarly, one more example let us take here. There is an equation N is equal to 1 by 2L under root T by mu. Say this is the equation given to us. What is what out of that one? First of all, we need to know before checking the correctness of that equation. So if you take this N, that's what is called as linear frequency. That is represented by N in this equation. And L is the length part of it. Length of, in fact, the vibrating string. And T is now going to be the tension in this vibrating string. Tension, in other words, we can call it as force. And what is this mu here? This is linear density, or you can even call it as linear mass also. So these are the four different quantities given in this equation for us. N is linear frequency, L is length, T is tension, which is otherwise called the force or the weight that is attached to the end of that vibrating string like, and mu is either linear mass or linear density like we can call it. Whether this equation is correct or not, we just have to check now. Again, let us write the dimensional formula of that quantity which is towards our left in that equation. N, that is linear frequency, which has T inverse, the dimensional formula for us. Now coming to the next one, let us write RHS, right hand side. 1 by L we have, that you better write it as L inverse. 1 by 2 being a constant, no dimensional formula for that. So 1 by L we can take up, that now can be written L inverse. After that, we have square root here. So write it as it is. Then what is this tension? It is M L T rest to the power minus 2. That is what is called weight or the force. So tension has the same dimensional formula of force. And what is linear density? Mass per unit length. That's what we call it as linear density of that string which we are considering in the case of sonometer experiment like. So if you take up this one, this mu can be written as M L inverse. That is the dimensional formula for mu. Let us now simplify this right hand side quantity. What do you have here? You see L inverse. This M gets cancelled. You are now left with root over L square T power minus 2. What is this root over L square T power minus 2? L inverse as it is we should write. This now becomes L T inverse. This L inverse and L, they get cancelled. Now what is ultimately left over? T inverse is left over. Now just look at the dimensional formula of the quantity which is given as N in the equation towards left, that has the same dimensional formula of those quantities given in the right towards the right hand side of that equation provided to us. So since these two are having the same dimensional formula, once again we can conclude that this equation given is dimensionally correct. So whether the equation given to us is dimensionally correct or not, we can make use of dimensional formulae and work that one out. That is one more example what we have considered here.